Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. For our presentation, we will focus on the promotion of technological entrepreneurship in Africa in the framework of NEPAD. And the objectives are to launch a debate and to reflect on opportunities of UNESCO and ISME collaboration and developing of a common program. The presentation will be structured into three parts. The first one will give the background of major economic problems facing in Africa and will present the development of the new partnership for Africa's development called NEPAD. The second part will highlight the importance of promoting technological entrepreneurship in SMEs and what has UNESCO done so far in this area. And the last part, we'll try to answer up to the question how can UNESCO and ISME join efforts to build capacities for technological entrepreneurship in Africa. The African continent presents lack of infrastructures, low local production, low research, low R&D expenditures. As you can see, 44 of the less developed countries are in Africa, which means that their per capita GDP is less than $900. With regard to SMEs, the predominance of micro enterprises is in the informal sector of the economy. So there is an urgent need to generate economic growth, promote human capacities in science and technology, because today the average is of 18 scientists and engineers per million people in Africa. As you may know, in 2001, the African countries have adopted the NEPAD, which is a holistic vision for Africa, a statement of problems and also a program of action for its socio-economic recovery. The major principles of NEPAD are good governance, African ownership and regional integration. The international community and the United Nations systems were called to organize the support for African countries in accordance to the principles of NEPAD. And to underline this importance, the heads of state of the G8 countries have nominated their own personal representatives to NEPAD. Just to give you a quick overview of the NEPAD structure, the most important body is the heads of state and Government Implementation Committee, which considers the proposed action plans and organizes for the review of their implementation. Also, the coordinating secretariat of NEPAD is hosted by South Africa in Pretoria. Today, NEPAD has officially become the program of the African Union and is progressively integrated into the strategic plan of the Union. In the NEPAD's vision document, there is an explicit recognition of the role of science and technology as engines of economic growth and sustainable development. As UNESCO's mission is to promote education, science, culture for peace and development, we try to concentrate our efforts on actions that will lead to job creations, human capacity reinforcement, technology development, and innovation. In addition to NEPAD, we can quote other initiatives for poverty reduction through the development of science and technology. For instance, there is a special task force that is looking over the side of science, technology, and innovation, and calls the policymakers in the developing countries to promote business activities in science and technology, and particularly foster the growth or the creation of small and medium enterprises. UNESCO has been designated as lead agency of the NEPAD Science and Technology Cluster of UN agencies working in Africa, and This cluster will focus on the NEPA Science and Technology Initiative aimed at the explicit application of science and technology for industrialization and economic growth. It will also mainstream science and technology into other NEPAD initiatives, such as the Environment Initiative, the Infrastructure Initiative. Having this responsibility, UNESCO has participated in the organization of the first NEPAD Ministerial Conference on Science and Technology that took place in November 2003. We are also collaborating for the preparation of the second one, which will be held this year in September. The first conference led to the establishment of the NEPAD Council of Ministers of Science and Technology and has adopted the outline plan of action of science and technology. One of its flagship programs highlights the need for SMEs development in industry. In their declaration, the ministers for science and technology called for a paradigm shift of science policies and institutional mechanisms to innovation. In order to take into consideration the outcomes of this first ministerial conference, UNESCO has decided to launch a series of African sub-regional workshops to build capacities in technological entrepreneurship in SMEs. The first workshop took place in Nigeria this year in March and was preceded by a one-day conference on innovation. The main objective of this workshop were to review the good practices and current trends of technological entrepreneurship training and outreach programs in higher educational institutions, and this with view to establish enterprises leading to the creation of jobs. The observation during the workshop preparation and the general conclusions were that, except in South Africa, very little activities for the promotion of technological entrepreneurship exist in sub-Saharan Africa. UNESCO is also implementing other activities in Africa, such as the University Industry Science Partnership Program, UNISPA, which supports the indigenous technology development through transfer of research results using the partnership between universities and industries. The Africa UNISPA activities include conferences, dissemination of information through newsletters, occasional reports, websites, publication, and award of grants to enable the universities and industries cooperate in the transformation of specific research to a technology. One result that falls into the UNISPA's logic is the establishment of a technological entrepreneurship chair in the Tshwane University in South Africa, in partnership with two European universities in Netherlands and Germany. They are willing to continue working in the same direction to fulfill the needs of NEPAD in the particular area of SMEs development. To better carry on this mission, UNESCO is seeking for partnerships. We are official SMEs members since October 2004, and we find that ISME is implementing many interesting activities in terms of partnerships, joint project training programs, and we think that the ISME Association is a great platform and an opportunity for the support of SMEs development all over the world. Our objective will be to see Africa as a more active partner into the ISME Association. We consider this meeting as an opportunity also to launch concrete proposals for collaboration between the UNESCO and INSME, including members but also non-members of the INSME Association, to establish partnership for Africa's development. For example, we were thinking of some ideas that could be discussed. For example, the establishment of a special UNESCO INSME committee that may propose and develop some special projects. We can also think to make an inventory of potential partners in Africa in the area of SMEs. Also, the training needs in Africa are enormous, so we can think together of possible joint training programs, and the event in Tunisia could be a first start. Other possibility could be to develop twinning programs and mentoring of public and private organizations. We are very thankful to be INSME official member, and we are looking forward to reinforcing our collaboration towards the development of technological entrepreneurship and SMEs in Africa. Thank you very much for your attention.